Today we're checking out the latest Gemma, and this is a Google model QAT. This is quantization aware training. This is yielding a much, much smaller size. So we're gonna check that out today and just run it through some very informal testing, see if we get similar responses. I usually wouldn't come back and revisit a model like this in an additional review, except for I am just really impressed with what is going on with Gemma 3, especially when we look at the size differences and your ability to run this in a much smaller GPU. Gemma 327B, and that is the QAT on the left-hand side and the FP16 on the right-hand side. As you saw, there was a substantial difference in the tokens per second. On the QAT side, we got 36 and 174. On the FP16, we got 14 response tokens per second and just 97 prompt tokens per second. Now, if we look here, I'm gonna validate for you that the QAT, we've got the same seed, we've got the same settings, we've got 16K set for both of these. This allows both of them to run on the quad 3090 rig in full VRAM. So we won't see any performance degradation because it's swapping out to system RAM here. And you can see both of them set with the exact same settings. And if you're interested in learning a little bit more about the details, you can of course check the linked in the description below, Google for Developers article on their Google AI site. The 27B drops from 54 gigabytes in the prior BF16 all the way down to 14 gigabytes in the latest quantization, which is essentially a Q4. So seeing somebody claim that a Q4 could perform the same as a BF16 set off alarm bells to me, like many others, and I wanted to test it out. I've got to say, this is, sit down, this is some good stuff. And if you're looking for other things to do while you're sitting down, be sure to hit up digitalspaceport.com, where I've got guides for everything that you can run through to get a setup on this exact kind of a system or any system. Tons of different builds out there, but the software side of it is all the same. And I've got a very good, simple copy paste kind of click, 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 get you up and running guide. And of course you can check all the videos in the channel history as well. Tons of those. Be sure to hit like and subscribe. Big shout out and thank you to the channel members. I do appreciate it very much. So jumping over to a new chat, we're gonna queue up the same two models here again on the same sides. And that's set one question two. And we'll take a look at what their outputs are. So definitely you can see the difference in speed quite substantial between the QAT and the FP16. However, if we look at what that tokens per second looked like, that was 34 response tokens per second and 1,214 prompt tokens per second. So that one was 14 tokens per second and about 1,100 prompt tokens per second. It looks like both of them answered and backed it up, but the amount of justification that QAT went into here substantially larger than what we got out of the FP16. All right, next up, we're gonna ask it to write a random sentence about a cat, then tell me the number of words that you wrote in that sentence, tell me the third letter in the second word of that sentence, and tell me whether that's a vowel or a consonant. This one is really just checking precision and the ability to follow instructions. Third letter, second word in the QAT is a U in Fluffy. It did get that correct, and it got that that is a vowel. The sentence, the fluffy calico napped peacefully in a sunbeam, is replicated also in the FP16. It did a couple extra steps here, but it came out with the same sentence. That probably being related to the 42069 seed that I have pinned between both of these. I think that's pretty interesting. Yeah, we got the correct answer out of both of them, both doing pretty well at this point. Next up, let's go ahead and toss a new chat window over here, add in our FP16, and we're gonna ask it to reproduce the first 100 decimals of pi. This one should be very easy for an LLM. It's not generating pi, it is literally just recalling numbers out of its kind of encyclopedic dictionary, if you will, of knowledge. It did get this correct on the left-hand side, it looks like to me. 0679 is how that should end. On the right-hand side, okay, so FP16 definitely got this wrong. And next up, we're gonna do Pico de Gato and ask it from a specific time period where the cat is and what the cat is doing. At 3:14 p.m., Pico should be in the window napping. So at 3:14 p.m., Pico is in the sleeping phase. This one failed to tell me, though, where Pico was. So the QAT did not catch that part of the instructions, because the instructions specifically ask, where and what is Pico de Gato doing? Completely omitted the fact that it's in the window in the entire analysis on the QAT side. The FP16 side did get that one correct, however. I think it's very close. It's much closer than what we might expect if we were looking at a Q4 to the FP16. This feels like, I don't want to overstate it, but this feels like a very solid advancement for how you are training and handling quantization. And I would love to see additional people that are producing, you know, model production facilities. I mean, the people with the GPUs, right? I'd love to see more of them able to produce quants in this fashion, because this does have a much higher quality vibe to it than what you're going to get off of a Q4. And I think what we're seeing is that this is fairly comparable. Now, we did have a couple misses here. I mean, I'd say those are a couple pretty big misses, but the fact that you're able to run a much larger context window also on the QAT, and also, you know, not need to have a massive rig, have a small rig to run a, you know, reasonably intelligent, you know, fairly decent productivity model. Gemma 3, not your coding expert, not your scientific deep dive expert, but probably one of the best all-arounders. I mean, if you're thinking of a generalized assistant, like an office assistant or something, Gemma 3 is really good at that. I know Gemini, the kind of big brother of Gemma, maybe in that kind of paradigm, it has, I believe, a 10 million context window. So I would challenge them to release a larger than 128K context window for the QAT, especially because there are a lot of people out there that would partake in that larger context window. So overall, we still do use Gemma 3 as our daily driver in the house, and it is darn good. And my wife uses this quite a bit for marketing, market planning, even things as crazy as image analysis, which I think, yeah, let's do that. Let's go ahead and do that just real quick here. We're going to do a little bit of image analysis. She asked me to include this one in there because she thought this was pretty cool. And I saw some of the results that it got, and I was impressed. I'm going to ask it for the emotion that I'm displaying here. And you can see this is me after quite a bit of frustration. I would say a little bit exasperated would be kind of where I was at when I took that photo. That one didn't make the thumbnail, I don't think, but definitely I was feeling a little bit exasperated. Okay, so QAT says, based on the photo, you appear to be displaying a combination of thoughtfulness and explanation. So that's not necessarily what I'm picking up. So I would say QAT did not get it just based on that. If you look on the right-hand side, this is the FP16, and you can see that this is actually, it used the word that I used, exasperation, perhaps a bit of exasperation, and that is definitely how I felt. The hand gestures, it talks about my facial expression, a slight furrow of the brow and somewhat serious expression. Definitely, it looks like I would rate the analysis of the FP16 higher than the QAT. What emotion do you see me with here? And so this is me excited because I've got some JBODs in the trunk, and I was super happy about having JBODs in the trunk. I was also pretty tired, and it even features in on things like my eyes are very wide, very alert, raised eyebrows, open mouth, and visible teeth. Yep, got that. Red light. This red light was actually just a side effect of poor camera, if I'm not mistaken. I'm pretty sure that's what it was. And 34 tokens per second on that. Now let's see what the FP16 said. Based on the image, you appear to be exhibiting a strong sense of excitement and anticipation, possibly bordering on shock or astonishment. You know, 60 discs in one JBOD is a bit of astonishment the first time you fire it up and you see all those discs present. So yes, it is exciting. You can find more of those kind of videos, by the way, just by checking the channel history. Wide eyes, yes, very wide eyes. Open mouth, red lighting. So it does go through most of the kind of analysis with the same key points, looking at eyebrows, mouth, lighting, eyes. I would say I'm almost smiling, but I think I caught that picture at a little bit of a weird time for a smile. And yeah, it looks like I'm very stimulated in that photo. I am very stimulated. I do love JBODs, and I cannot lie. So let's move on to the next one here. Now this one's exciting because I literally have This Excites Me in it. So it was exciting. And this was when I was running service line in the house for the garage data center. 3 years ago, maybe 3.5 years ago. And yeah, the attic is a terrible place to be pulling service line yourself, but I got some aviators on. Definitely a lot of very heavy cable. That conductor definitely weighed me down, definitely hard to pull, even though it was aluminum. The main breakdown of the photo, main subject, man smiling with camera, dark hair and a beard. He's wearing sunglasses and appears to be in good spirits. Setting in context, the background suggests outdoor, check, correct. Most prominent clue is the large gray charging cable. Okay, so it's not a charging cable for an EV, but I can definitely see how that looks like. It would be a charging cable for an EV. Service wire, pretty thick and chunky. You can find out more about running data center power also in the video that I've got linked here if that kind of stuff interests you. This is a little bit of an insane home data center I got going on, in case you haven't noticed. Okay, let's see what FP16 says. So I would say QAT did decent on that analysis. FP16 here, let's take a look. This is a selfie taken by a man, appears excited about a charging an electric vehicle. This did get electricity excites me. So it did actually read electricity excites me, even though that's in a fairly bad font for readability. In my opinion, that's impressive that it can read that. Detailed description. Man, dark curly hair, kind of curly, smiling at the camera, background bright, definitely was a hot summer day. Foreground, the photo occupies a gray charging cable and the charging port. So definitely a charging port is not visible anywhere here. The kind of electrical tape that I've got it bound up with there maybe is what it's mistaking that for. I'm not sure. Did get the words correct. And overall, positive, enthusiastic energy. Yeah, I got it done. It really sucked, but I got it done. And so I would say that that is a fairly decent analysis by both of them, but minor parts of it are missed. See if they can get that I've got aviators on. Jimma327B FP16 gets aviators. However, Wayfarer style is what QAT thought that I was wearing. Definitely the FP16 did get that one. I'm gonna have to actually look to see whether or not the QAT did, but you might know, you might not know. People running FP16 or BF16 is like none. People that are running INT8 or Q8, that's a lot of people. And you get usually a tremendous benefit by running a little bit better than the Q4. The Q4s kind of have a rep for falling off at the edges. And maybe that's what we saw a little bit here, but it's not as consistently bad as I was expecting. Not by a long shot. So I feel like the evaluation, while completely non-scientific and completely just me vibe checking it here, is kind of useful. I think that you should definitely give the QAT a roll if you are looking for a generalist. If you're looking for a specialist, like I said, maybe not your model here. But definitely if you're looking for a generalist, pretty strong contender. So I look forward to reading your comments down below. Be sure to drop those. Also, while you're down there, hit like, subscribe. Feel free to ring the bell if you want to get notified when new videos drop. And of course, you can check out the channel history where you can learn things like what you would be able to expect building a rig for blank dollars and what it might be able to run at, as well as some crazy stuff that's like running DeepSeek 671B locally, just kind of fun things also. Let me know what you think. I think this is a great advancement. Once again, big hats off to the team that made this happen. And this is the kind of thing that when we see iterative advancements, one after another, and you start chaining these onto each other, which probably in a couple months, we'll see these kind of reasoning models that have QAT that is very good, be able to really hopefully make some headway as far as the quality of what we see for LLMs. Whether they get us to AGI or not, well, you let me know what you think in the comments below. Everybody have a great rest of your day, and I will see you next time.